Hey, so do you absolutely hate being watched? And it's like, you know, a situation like this where you're just walking down the street and it feels like the driver's eyes are on you, they're watching you, they're judging you. Well, if so, stick around because in this video, I want to help you understand why that's happening, why it feels so uncomfortable, you know, doing something as simple as this, walking down the street. And I really want to help you understand what's driving that whole dynamic. And then I'm going to tell you how you can start to overcome this feeling so you can live as a free person without giving a shit about what other people think, okay? All right, so a lot of you have mentioned this and I get it. It can make, you know, going from point A to point B just seem like such an all-out event because you're battling in your mind. You know, you're thinking, are they watching? Are they not watching? Are they judging me? Are they not judging me? And sometimes the feeling's so strong, you lose your focus, you know, you become robotic and you're just trying, you're struggling so bad to just come across as normal and like you don't care. And I remember this feeling of being watched and judged. It's like one of the worst parts of social anxiety, right? Like I remember being at work even, something as simple as just filling up my water bottle was just stressful because, you know, there'd be a couple people behind me. I'm filling up the water bottle. Like, am I causing them, you know, am I causing them to wait too long? Oh my God, am I coming across as nervous? Do they know I'm nervous? I'm not even thinking about, you know, what's in front of my face, which is just, I just got to get some water. I got to get my water bottle full and just be on my way. But it's like, I couldn't even focus on that because it's like my mind and my body just get hijacked at the thought of people's eyes on me. And it's like, I have no focus whatsoever up here. And it's the worst place to be, right? And you know, I've heard some of the advice out there. It's like people say, well, you know, they're likely not judging you. Everybody's thinking about themselves, so don't worry about it. People aren't as worried about you as you think and it's all in your head, blah, blah, blah. And I think that's, you know, that's just like this intellectual thing that you could try to convince yourself up here, but at the same time, it's not rooted in reality. I mean, what if they are judging? You know, then what are you gonna do? And it's like, the thing with that is you're focusing on the wrong thing, okay? The thing to realize here is that you've lost your presence. That's a huge thing. You've lost your presence. You're not even in your body in that moment. You've already fixated into the future. People are judging you and you fixated into this idea that people's eyes are on you. They're thinking these things of you and you're no longer present. And so essentially you've gotten triggered. It's people's eyes on you, or maybe even just the prospect of people's eyes on you have triggered you enough to evoke a stress response in you. And part of this stress response, right, this fight or flight kind of stress response that we all have, when it goes off, it's always going to be attached to the worst case scenario, okay? So in your mind, when that happens, when the stress response happens, your mind is going to fixate on that these people are watching you and they are judging you. And you're not going to be present enough to gather real-time evidence to dispute that. And that's a really big thing because when you lose the present moment, when you lose your presence, you lose touch with reality. And I'll give you an example, right? You could feel like there's all these eyes on you, they're watching you, they're judging you. So you move robotic, right? You move robotically, you move in a way where nobody thinks anything's up. The driver going by doesn't tell, or you can't tell that you're nervous. And you put in all this effort to come across as normal, and then you look up and he's not even paying attention to you. You've lost touch with reality. And that's the thing, when you lose the present moment, you're no longer living in reality. So the key is to, when you find yourself fixated on the outcome, when you're attached to that outcome, you know, they are watching, they are judging you, and it feels so real inside, and it's something just hijacks your mind and your body. The key is to realize you've already gone into this fight or flight response and what sets it off, okay? The fact that you are going into this fight or flight or this survival response based on somebody watching you and judging you means that somewhere you've made an association with the judgments of other people with mere survival, right? So there's a bigger picture here. You gotta figure out what's happened during your experiences where you've made this association with the judgments of other people with such survival, with such deep, painful emotion and feelings that it completely hijacks you, okay? So think about it this way. People have anxiety, right? Generalized anxiety. And if they go and they go into a group or they have to speak in front of people or they're in one-on-one conversations, it doesn't spike their anxiety. Their general anxiety is completely at a baseline level. It doesn't change at the judgments or the risk of being judged by other people because they don't have that fear, right? For you, because you have this fear of being judged, you know, walking along a street like this and people, the fear of people's eyes on you, or maybe you have trouble eating in front of people, maybe you have a hard time performing your tasks at work when people are watching you, it's the judgments of other people that are triggering you to that point where you've gone into this survival mechanism, the fight or flight goes off, and then your brain fixates on that worst case scenario. So that's what you wanna start exploring in order to get long-term freedom, in order to not care what other people think of you, and even if they do judge you, not be fazed by it, right? And that comes from healing your past trauma, healing those past experiences where you were judged by people, where you were pointed and laughed at, right? Where you were rejected. So you have to go back and heal the past traumas, the past experiences, so they no longer bother you in this present moment, because that's what's hijacking you in the present moment and taking you out of the present moments. Remember, so feelings, they're like time travelers. So when you have a memory that happens to you in the past, a memory is always stored with a feeling. So think about it this way. If you feel like you've been betrayed by a friend, and you think all back to that moment, you think back to the memory, what comes up? Anger, resentment, rage, right? You have the memory, but you also have the feelings that come with it. And the same goes for this social anxiety or this trigger, like you're being watched. It's like you have the memory, but those are the feelings that are stored with that memory is what's coming in the present moment and making you feel like it's happening in the present, kicking you into survival and making you fixated on that outcome like it's really happening right now in the present moment. Okay, so if you want to learn the exact steps for how you do that, download your free ebook. I'm going to link it below the video. If you're on Instagram, I'm going to put it in the bio. And so download your free ebook. I lay out the exact steps, the exact 5 steps that you need to break free from this for good. And so you can just walk around free as you will, as you deserve to, so you can live a full life. You can live free. You don't have to limit yourself in what you do because you're worried about what other people think. Okay, so I highly encourage you to download the ebook. It's got the exact steps for you to break free from good. And then if you need more support, join my private Facebook group. I'm gonna link it below the video and in the bio as well. And the Facebook group is really great because you can come in there and get support. You can come in there, I'm in there, you can ask me questions, you can get more guidance in there. I'm constantly doing Facebook Lives and live trainings. And there's a great group of people in there all struggling with the same thing. So you can come in, connect, build relationships, and get the support you need. So I hope to see you in there, and I will see you on the inside. All right, peace out.